And we're live. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Emmet's Place. How's everyone doing this evening? Oh, look at the video.
Oh, my God.
All right, we made some corrections to the connections, but it looks a little fuzzy. Keep it rolling. What do you say?
Next week
we'll do the Ethernet. Yeah, I know. So I just got an Ethernet cable shipped to my house, and it just arrived. So we're going to see what's happening with this. And it should be cool. We hope everyone had a nice week. It's hard to believe this is the 7th installment. Here we go. We're going to start off as our mentor and our Baba, our beacon of light, Mr. Ron Carter's birthday today, May 4th. May the 4th be with you. And we're going to start off with a Ron Carter composition entitled Eibenstrauss. Thank you. How's everyone doing tonight? Thanks for joining us. Thanks for being with us here live at Emmet's Place. Here we are, another Monday. This is number 7, but we're on week 8. Thanks so much for being with us. It means a real lot. It means a great deal to be able to deliver some music in this time and for you to receive it on our new medium of Facebook live stream. If you don't know these guys by now, we do this every week. On the drums and the cymbals, that's Mr. Kyle Poole. On the double bass fiddle, the one and only Mr. Russell Hall. And yours truly, Emmet Cohen on the piano. Thanks so much for tuning in. That last tune we played was called The Loneliest. It's called The Loneliest by Mr. Russell Hall himself. Tribute to the high priest of bebop, Thelonious Monk, which we played his tune before that called Reflections.
No, that was Ruby, my dear.
Oh, that was Ruby, my dear. Excuse me. We played Ruby, my dear, followed by The Loneliest. Good thing I got Russell here to keep me honest. And we played a whole pile of music before that. We started out with a Ron Carter tune called Eibenstrass. Where do we go from there? We played something from Finian's Rainbow called Old Devil Moon. What else we do? We were just jamming and just having a good time and playing. So we're going to continue the music. We hope you're cooking something nice, or you're sitting down and watching this, or you're just passing through on Facebook or YouTube. It really does mean a lot that you're here. And yeah, we're going to keep some music going for you. This is an original song of mine that I recorded almost 6-7 years ago with Mr. Brian Lynch. This is called Distant Hallow. Thank you. That was Distant Hallow. Distant Hallow. How's everyone doing on here tonight? So, you nice people out there. We see you, Ben Yunsen. How you doing, man? Oh, man. It's so cool to connect with everyone around the world. I know there's a lot of different countries, a lot of different people tuning in, a lot of different times. And it's so funny, when you play in a club, you know exactly who you're playing for because they're right in front of you. They're either all eating dinner, or they're all sitting in a concert and watching you, or they're all on a date and partying and you're playing a party, or they're all, you know, at an event and you're playing background music. The number of gigs that we do, but here it's so strange because everyone's doing something different. So the music exists in so many different places at once. I think it's a kind of an amazing thing, but it's also definitely challenging as musicians to try and fill the need for the music in all the various settings.
What y'all think?
Yeah.
But we're gonna play something that was requested by our peeps Jim and Debbie Malone, and this is something that David Fathead Newman would play Ray Charles Made Famous. It's called Hard Times. Dedicated to the time we live in, the corona age, the hard times.
Thank you.
That's hard times right there. Hope you all are doing all right in the hard times. We know it's not easy being inside. We know a lot of places are reopening, and it's not safe even for some of you to be out there. We don't know if it's safe for us to be out there. We don't know much, but we do know that when we don't know, we look to the music, and it helps guide us, that's for sure. So we're gonna guide our way over to our bass player, Mr. Russell Alexander Hall. We're gonna feature him on something of his choosing. He's making a choice.
One of those tough life decisions. Thank you.
Russell Hall on the bass, on the bass.
Thank you.
That's for our man Adam Long, who requested Round Midnight. Felicia. And Felicia. Bye, Felicia. Hi, Felicia. Oh, it's been a pleasure playing for you all tonight. Thank you so much for being here. And we're gonna take you home now. That's Mr. Kyle Poole on the drums. That's Mr. Russell Hall on the bass. We want to give a big birthday shout out to Stephanie Bearline. She's celebrating her 32nd birthday in my hometown of Montclair. So shout out to you. And shout out to all y'all who are tuning in every week. We really do appreciate it. It's been awesome to connect with so many people through the world. And we can't thank enough Jazz Corner. Visit their Facebook and website. We want to thank the Cream Candy Jazz Orchestra this week, who's helping to sponsor this gig tonight. And you can check out their website. They're doing a lot of cool things, and we may do a masterclass next week, which was supposed to happen yesterday, but is getting rescheduled due to technical difficulties. But we'd love for you to join our masterclass too, so you can find out more at the links in the description. And we also love to thank Mac Avenue and the American Pianist Association, and Jazz Memes, and so many others who Smoke Jazz Club, Birdland Jazz Club. Don't forget to, you know, support the local jazz clubs, buy some gift certificates, do what you can. If you'd like to donate to us, you can do so. There's a brand new membership exclusive program that we do special concerts and things like that for anyone who wants to further support on an ongoing basis. And we're getting ready to print vinyl copies of Dirty in Detroit, and all the subscribers will get one of those. And yeah, so we just thank you for tuning in. You can also, you know, donate on all the regular platforms and go to the Russell Hall Bass Tuning Foundation and the Kyle Poole Snare Drum Reheading Foundation. And the Emmet Cohen Piano Tuning Foundation too, because, you know, gets out of tune when we bang on it. But not for a little while. We're waiting until the quarantine's over. And yeah, that's about it. We thank you for tuning in. Maybe we'll play one more little tune to sign off, but you can always reach out. And I believe tomorrow's Giving Tuesday, so support your local nonprofits and all the organizations like Vail Jazz and many others who support us on an ongoing basis. So we do really appreciate all that. Don't forget to stay in touch. Sign up for a newsletter. Tune back in. We got a cool video collaboration quarantine jam coming out with Wyclef Gordon this week. And it's really pretty good and hilarious. Once again, that's Kyle Poole on the drums. Mr. Russell, Alexander Hall on the bass. And yours truly, Emmet Cohen. We got a little request on the Jazz Corner page for Ain't Misbehaving, so we're going to maybe take you home with a little piece of Ain't Misbehaving and maybe something else. We love you dearly. Happy birthday to John Lewis, who just turned 100. We played something for him the other day, and we'll get to him next week. And Mr. Percy Heath, who just would have been 97. And Russell Hall's coming up in a little while, so if you want to send him a birthday gift, you know, reach out to him and show him some love. Thank you. Russell Hall playing the bass. Russell Hall playing the bass. Kyle Poole on those drums. That's Kyle Poole on the drums. Whoa. Yo, it's truly Emmet Cohen on the piano. We're here every week, live from Emmet's place in Harlem, amongst all the jazz spirits and the energy up here. All the great artists that lived here and created here. And you walk down the street in Harlem, and you get some of that energy, you get some of that vibe. And we're bringing that vibe right to you through the airwaves. So we love you. We appreciate you. If you have the means, go to visit the website, emmetcohen.com. Check out more information, and if you'd like, drop me a line and we'll say hello. You can always donate to the band, and if you can't figure it out, just ask me how. We'd love to hear from you. We'd love to see you in the jazz club when this is all over, so sign up for the mailing list and stay in touch. We'll be back with some brand new music and some other stuff next week. Thanks so much. Thank you all so much, and good night.
Thank you.
Any of you want to say anything? Thank you.
We'd like to thank all the people watching. If you could see my face, you'll see that I'm saying thank you. Thank you for listening to our music, and thank you for being so beautiful out there. Ron Carter, if you're out there, happy birthday to you, Professor. Thank you for all that you do as we learn about this music called jazz. Kyle, you want to say anything?
I just want to say thank you for all the people who've donated cases of wine. Cheers.
And thank you to, you know, thank you to Emmet Cohen because he set all this stuff up and it's difficult. So thank you for what you're doing. And it's very lovely and we're doing it and we're trying to figure out the virtual world. So, yeah. Thank you, Emmet.
You want to take some questions?
Yeah, let's take some questions.
People said, how do you keep the piano in tune?
Someone wants to know how to keep the piano in tune. And the best way to keep the piano in tune is play with a nice touch into the bottom of the key. My mentor Shelley Berg taught me that, but you can also hear it when you listen to Hank Jones. He's the master at that. He's able to play the piano that's out of tune and make it sound like it's in tune.
Let's see what the people are saying. They're just saying thank you.
Well, we could say thank you too. So nice that you guys are enjoying this stuff, you know. It's hard to, like, adjust to not playing for people and just, you know, just playing to a screen. And you don't get that instant response.
Applause.
But.
Booze, anything.
Or just any kind of human interaction whatsoever, you know. And so we're trying to figure this stuff out. You know, how to, what is virtual etiquette, you know?
Virtual etiquette.
Yeah. I think we're doing an all right job. I hope the sound is syncing up with the actual video.
Did Kyle play at the world stage as a kid? Kyle, you want to talk about the world stage?
Yeah, Kyle. Who asked that question?
I don't know. I already went so fast.
Yes. I used to. Okay. Well, the world stage is a cultural center in Leimert Park. A cultural center in Leimert Park, which is in Los Angeles, California. Leimert Park is a cultural center in itself. Like I said, Leimert Park is a cultural center, and the world stage is in Leimert Park, and my friend Aisha, her auntie, who I call Auntie A, used to take me to the world stage every Monday, me and Aisha, to take jazz drum lessons. I was about 11 years old, and there were a group lesson, so there are 8 or 9, you know, young drummers like myself, and a guy, a drummer, who was an understudy of Billy Higgins. His name is Cornell Fowler. He would walk us through just the basics of trying to get the ride cymbal beat together and play a bossa nova and be free on the drums, and the lesson was only about 20 minutes at a time, but it was so much help for me, and I think is the reason why I'm playing drums today. In fact, Billy Higgins, is it my shirt too tight? Anyway, I have a tattoo of Billy Higgins' signature on my arm for that reason, because he's the one who started the world stage, and I love Billy. He's one of my favorite drummers, if not favorite drummer, and his contribution is why I love this music and play this music today.
Talk about your favorite wine.
Oh, my favorite wine is like, I mean, I know it's so cliche, but like a Cabernet Sauvignon is gonna do the thing. Just any bold red wine, Montepulciano, you know, like a Rioja or something from Spain, like any just bold red wine. Thank you for sending this wine, though. I can't recall the taste, but if it's bold and red, I like it. Not sweet, no sweet. Like dark chocolate and blackberries, but like not sweet blackberries, you know? Anyway, that's enough about my wine taste.
Conrad Gale wants to know when we're coming back to Toronto. Well, we don't know when we're going anywhere right now, but maybe next summer for the festival. Someone wants to know about Jamaica, man.
Jamaica? What do you want to know?
Well, maybe where you're from.
Well, I can tell you all about Jamaica. I lived there for about...
They said they can't hear us.
They can't hear us? Okay, I'll make it brief as possible. I was born and raised in Kingston, Jamaica. Lived there for about 13 years. And I lived in Kingston 6, which is like Barbican, Matilda's Corner area, for those of you familiar with Kingston or Jamaica at all. Like right next to Mona. I went to Mona Prep School, which was like, you know, kindergarten through sixth grade. You guys would call it, grade 6. And then I went to Woman's Boys, which was in downtown Kingston. And I went there for about a year and a half. And then I moved to South Florida, where I met Emmet Cohen. And we've been playing together since 2011. Yeah.
So. Man, we're a big family, and from our family to yours, we say goodnight. We say thank you so much, and we'll see you soon. We'll see you next Monday. Don't forget to stay in touch and do something positive in your life and do something nice for somebody, uplift somebody, read a book, make some art, and just enjoy life for what it is. So thank you all so much. Peace and blessings. Mm-hmm.